Hello everyone, this is Twins Light Channeling as you all know, and today I'm here with another very important message, which is a soul counterpart, divine masculine channeling, and you'd be very happy to hear this message. So just stick with this audio till the end and just listen to me carefully, because I have a lot of information which is going to be very beneficial for all of you. Okay, so we'll start with it, and this is to let you know that I'm reading from my notebook, which I use to record and write down the messages I receive as channeling. So you might feel like I'm reading something, so that's because of my notes only. Okay, so this masculine is highly awakened now, and he is in his senses. Okay, he has been very silent these days, and he's actually constantly taking a step back before reacting or saying anything to anyone. He has been thinking a lot about his feminine and reminiscing old memories which he shared with her, with his feminine. I'm sorry for that. And he's visualizing a lot. He's visualizing having a quality time with his feminine. He actually wants to have some quality. Sorry. He actually wants to have some quality time spent with her. He actually wants to spend, some quality time with her. Sorry for my mistakes. So he's visualizing about being on a romantic date with his feminine, or taking a trip with his feminine to some kind of beach resorts. And here these three places are highlighted, so you might get an offer from him to take a trip with him to Maldives, Goa, or Bali. These are highlighted, but these doesn't have to be necessarily the destination that you both are going to go when you meet or when you plan out what's next in your journey. Okay, some of you may actually like to go to some hill station or anywhere you would like to go personally, but those three places were highlighted, so I just said them or told you about them. So the main message is here that the union phase has literally started, and this masculine has already broken up or is breaking up with a lot of karmic entanglements, or I should say breaking free from a lot of karmic entanglements as well as a lot of toxic relationships in his life. He has cut contact with few of his friends as well who were taking advantage of him, and on the top of it, they were purposely filling in his ears negatively about you to make you look bad in his eyes and impose their own partial opinions and the judgments they had or they have about you. And they were thinking that your masculine is entitled to them in some way, and he has to listen to them, what they are saying, and how he should be living his life according to them. But he is now breaking free from all of those people and all of those entanglements which he himself has been living with or was entertaining. So he has cut ties with his toxic family members as well, but still there is the energy of a mother figure that is still lingering around him. She's probably keeping an eye on him or onto you as well, so just be careful about that. Though this masculine has taken a strong stand for you in front of her and or in front of all of the family members, and he has declared that his woman is going to be you, whether these people like it or not, or accept it or not, but he has decided or is going to make a decision very soon that he's not going to sacrifice his happiness so that these people can be comfortable in their own mess. Because we all know they are like, if we don't want to grow up, we will not let anyone else grow up in our family. This is the thing, this is the dysfunctional pattern that has been going on since ages and centuries, which needs to be broken, and it is going to get broken soon, or the process has already started. One more important point that has came to me was that this mother figure doesn't want to feel that she has been left alone in the dark. Maybe she has the abandonment issues many women have, and we all know why we have such abandonment issues and abandonment wounds, because we've been treated unfairly, and this has been going on from ages and centuries again. So she also has such kind of patterns and wounds, but the problem is that one has to take responsibility for their own healing. Okay, we cannot say that if one is elder or if one is a mother, so they get the privilege to be mean or to think in a way where they feel like they are entitled to get everything at the cost of destroying somebody else's life or somebody else's happiness. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say here, right? So the thing is that she's still trying to revolve around him to get his attention, or just to feel comfortable, or just to be in the picture, because she doesn't want to feel that way where she has been left alone. But the thing is that there has been, or there is, a very unhealthy or codependent relationship between this pair of son and the mother, which universe is now working on and healing it for the highest good of all involved. This relationship or bond, whatever it is, in between this son and the mother, we all respect the relationship between a mother and a child, but the thing is that one needs to grow up and mature up, no matter who you are. Okay, and universe is not going to let you snatch and steal what belongs to somebody else because you are a mother, or you are a father, or you are a parent, or you are a sibling, or anything like that. Just to be clear. So it is going to get healed, and this is a message for the feminines who are listening to this audio. You are advised to be kind to this woman, to this mother figure, and be patient with her. Though you might just want to bang her head on the wall for the things she has done to you or is still doing to you, but still, universe is saying that universe is going to work on healing this toxicity or negativity that is going on into the situation, and universe is going to work in resolving these family issues that you are having at the moment. This was a very important message for the feminine. And one more thing that I would like to add here is that this message is not for everyone. Okay, if you are like literally feeling that somebody is getting very nasty with you and somebody is crossing limits, learn to take stand, but just be patient and don't fall into the trap of taking revenge. That's what I want you to know. Take a stand for yourself. Don't let anybody get comfortable abusing you or disrespecting you or insulting you, but just be patient and don't act impulsively or haphazardly, right? So universe is saying to you that there may be people in the situation or otherwise who will treat you very bad or will push your buttons, and you may surely get tempted to lose your patience in the process, and you may want to give them an answer or seek revenge into the situation, but universe is saying that don't do that. Just don't react at all. Promise yourself that you will never become a bad person like them to seek revenge. Universe is saying that it's my responsibility to give them an answer. Your responsibility is just to be very aware and mindful of the situation and just use your intuition. That's it. I will teach them a very good lesson. You just have to be patient, because your patience is going to get tested. That is what you need to understand. Okay? So a lot of karmic cycles are now wrapping up, and you can expect some kind of upheavals or turbulences going on around you or in your life, or it may happen soon. But this is all going to be temporary. Your path is actually getting cleared now, and as soon as the dust settles, you'll understand everything. Okay, metaphorically speaking. So this is not for everyone, but some of your masculines or one of your masculine's sibling, especially if she is a woman, that means if he has a sister, is actually going to face some sort of major harsh lessons and some really, really bad karma for slandering your name and or assassinating your character in front of others or in front of family members or in the community. This woman or this girl, depends on your situation, went out of her way to investigate about your past lovers, if you had, or your karmic partners, or is investigating to get information about people you have worked with, your workplaces, your employers, your associates or your colleagues. And she has been purposely spreading a lot of rumors or lies about you, or she has either blindly supported and accepted these lies or rumors just to satisfy her own ego, or use that information to stop the masculine from coming towards you. I hope you understand. So I received a very clear message for this woman, that the lines were like this, that it doesn't take much time before the table gets turned, before the tables get turned. Do harm others only as much as you can bear on yourself. So these were the lines. So I think that you all are smart enough to understand what does that mean. On the other hand, if it was you who has done such kind of thing to somebody, where you have slandered somebody's name or assassinated somebody's character or have just laughed onto somebody, I mean, just be careful, because what is coming, you won't like it. Don't ever use any negative words or say anything demeaning about anyone before you. I mean, don't even do that. Don't even do that. Never do that, because you have no idea how much you make the universe, how should I explain and what statement should I use here? You have no idea how upset the universe gets when you do that, because you don't know the whole picture. Okay? So before saying anything or before writing anything, even on the public pages, on social media, be very careful. People think it's normal. It's not normal. And it is not part of the human nature. Some people do that because they think everybody is doing, so it's kind of part of the human nature. It's not. Okay, coming back to your counterpart. He's planning on communicating with you to make a fresh start, and you might still be having some kind of resentment and bitterness in your heart towards him. And you might be feeling hurt by some of his actions or actions of his friends, which he didn't recognize in the past. Also, you are not quite sure if you would be able to be nice to him or to these people again in life, but source is saying to you that just be patient. You have to keep your calm and speak your truth in a calm manner, because he is very worried and scared about how you're going to react and respond if he approaches you with a message or some kind of communication. But at the same time, he needs to be real with you from now on, and he has to make sure, as well as you, that there are no more mixed signals coming from either side, no more back and forth, and no more free access to your energy only when it serves him. Do you understand? Okay. So now he has been, sorry, now he has become sure of the fact that you are the one. And you are the most important person in his life, because he has been receiving signs from the universe, from left, right, and center. And because of that, the universe is now integrating situations and circumstances to make you both meet or talk unexpectedly. And this is going to be happening in a very miraculous way. Okay, you will not see it coming. It can come from out of the blue, and you will be shocked, and you may feel like you don't know how to react in the situation, and you may impulsively react out of anger or resentment. That's why universe is saying just be calm. Universe is not saying to you to hold back and not speak your truth because you don't want to hurt him. If you do that, then again you will be repeating the same old cycle of people pleasing, actually, which you shouldn't be doing. So just be calm and patient and speak your truth, and don't let him think like he can come and say anything and act like nothing happened and you will be entertaining him. No. You can say that if you want to talk to me, be real and be clear. I will listen, but I am not going to act like nothing happened. So if you don't have the courage to speak your truth and provide both of us with some sort of clarity, please don't contact me till that time. And don't think that I am waiting for anything or anyone. You understand? You have to be diplomatic and real at the same time. So now the issue is that he is not actually worried about deciding on or concluding what this connection means or what this connection stands in his life. Now the issue is about breaking the silence and facing you with all the truth, and that is what is scaring him right now. So now, when the permanent union is actually arriving and is falling in your lap, I'm talking to the feminine right now, you are going to get tested on the lessons of forgiveness, acceptance, learning, and letting go. And he's going to be tested with the lessons of practicing courage, vulnerability, ego death, honesty, truthfulness, and faithfulness. And in facing these tests, there is a high chance that he might get hurt by your words or actions or reactions if you become bitter while dealing with him at the same time. Or I should say at this time. So it's like you both are going to get tested. His situation is also like where the sword is hanging on his head, whether he takes action or not. At the same time, you also have to be very careful with the sword you have in your hand, because you might cut yourself in the process if you use it without a thought. I hope I'm being very clear in explaining the point to you. I think I am, okay? And I should let you know that this man is already very depressed and is living with tons of regrets and remorse over hurting and betraying his feminine. His ego is still not diminished fully, but he's still working on it, okay? And he's slowly and surely changing his overall behavior too in order to get back with his feminine and heal the situation. So what you can do is that the feminines, I'm speaking to you, what you can do is that you can be in your power and still remain calm and collected at the same time in order to deal with him. Speak your truth, ask for truth, but don't enable or allow any past behaviors of either sweeping things under the rug or acting like nothing happened, or again letting him give you mixed signals and you throwing yourself off over him because you don't want to hurt him, or you are so hopeful about the reunion that you don't want to spoil the chance of having some time with him, or of being in reunion with him. Don't think like that. You have to be real and still maintain the boundaries. Just be real and try not to intimidate him on purpose to prove the point that you were right the whole time and he was wrong. He already knows that. But the thing is that you have to allow him to express that or say that to you. Don't force him to say that to you, that you was right and he was wrong. Just allow that to say. Just allow him to say that to you, okay? Even coming into reunion is a process. You're not going to get engaged or married on the same day and on the same time when he calls you or asks you to come on a date with him. There still needs to be a conversation between both of you where a lot of things will come up. And it's not, as I said, it's not always peaches and roses. Okay, you might break down in front of him, he might break down in front of you. You might still be processing a lot of anger and resentment, because it's not like that it has been a very casual relationship. You both have faced a lot of things which breaks down, which would break down a normal people, a casual human being. No, I should not say a casual human being. I should use a word where which more relates to a unconscious human being. Okay. So you both need to resolve your issues and clean the slate in order to have a fresh new start and a new beginning. Until and unless the past is not healed and released, a new beginning cannot happen. So allow that to happen. Okay? You understand? Okay, so this was the message and I'm going to end it here. Right now I have very different messages that have came to me, and I have already recorded them and written them on my notebook. So I will post them later. This is the message which is I'm going to post right now. So I just want to say thank you for being on this channel and blessing me and others with your lovely wishes and much love. Thank you.